And welcome to the Canadian Caribbean Association of Halton's Black History Month kickoff for 2023. Round of applause for us. Now we are so grateful to have each and every one of you people here and in person. So none of this, sorry, I'm on mute. We're actually not a virtual kickoff, but an actual in-person kickoff. And we're actually making real-life connections, as we did out there. So speaking of connections, our theme this year is about connecting communities. And what that means to me is bringing together Oakville communities and Burlington communities, or bringing together Milton and Georgetown and Acton, which is still worth the drive to Acton, I believe. But more than that, it's about extending Black communities with our allies. And within the D&I space, and embracing diversity, equity, and inclusion.
So proud of Oakville's history. Oakville and Black history come together throughout our history, and great things have been done, and more importantly, great things are going to be done as the CCH continues to connect our communities, and our communities are going to grow. There's going to be another 33,000 families joining us over the next 10 years, And when you look at which communities have been growing the fastest, the black community is one of the faster growing communities. And so many of those 33,000 new families will be new black families. And that will continue to strengthen this organization, and it will also enrich our community, just as our black co-founders have enriched our community throughout our history. I therefore proclaim February 2023 as Black History Month in the town of Oakville. Thank you.
So let me say thank you very much, everybody, for being here. Back in December at our music recital, I put the challenge out to everybody, and I said that I had booked the Oakville Center for Performing Arts and I needed 400 bums in the seats. And you guys really came through tonight, so thank you. In the summer of 2020, discussions began around building a community-led report to figure out what can be done to better provide Black, Indigenous, and people of color with a better sense of community and a greater sense of inclusion and belonging. Together, the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation, the Canadian Caribbean Association of Halton, Mending the Chasm, the Oakville Community Foundation partnered with Sheridan College, and we completed a research project. And those results were just recently published, and I'll just give you a couple of highlights. One of the highlights, there is a noticeable willingness to accept and agree that racism happens on a personal level, but an unwillingness for some of those institutions to recognize the existence of systemic racism. Another highlight, respondents said the traditional school system needs to be overhauled to reflect Canada's true history and include more diverse voices. A lot of respondents commented that there should be a better response to mental health and better relationships between the police and the community. A lot of respondents called on Oakville and Halton to rename public spaces to recognize racialized figures. And people even called out CCH for being in existence for over 45 years and not affecting enough change. And what these results really solidified is what it means for CCH to have four pillars. Those four pillars are the cornerstone of all of our activities, all of our programming, and everything that we undertake. Community, culture, education, and harmony. But here's what a lot of people who are outside of CCH don't know. While there's no question that CCH is a Black-led organization, CCH works to uplift the entire community. Just take a look at everybody around here. Everyone, 100%, we are uplifting everybody. And by doing so, the 43% of racialized and Indigenous people will do better. And the 3% of that 43%, that little group that are Black people, they in turn will also do better. And that's what we are pushing for. At CCH, we help people who are struggling, and we give everyone a sense of belonging. And from those 3% of Black people in Halton, we want you to know that we're not only Black in February. So for me, here's what success looks like. And these are the things we've done and pushed for. Both publicly funded school boards have brought on or are bringing on Black student success coaches. Roots Community Service in Peel and in Halton, partnered with CCH, have a student and family advocate program. And that program is a Black-led social worker that comes into schools together with a Black child and youth worker to help students and their families navigate the school system for better outcomes for themselves and their families. And here's what CCH did last year on a grassroots level to really put action behind those four pillars. And here's a big one. This past summer, we had 40 kids each day for 8 weeks at CCH's Black, Indigenous, and People of Color Day Camp. All Black camp counselors, all the volunteer staff were Black, Indigenous, or People of Color. Each week, kids went swimming, they learned to play steel pan, they made crafts, they had Afrocentric dance classes, and with the funding from our federal partners and our friends at the Oakville Community Foundation, with the assistance of the town of Oakville, we installed and created a 2,000 square foot community garden where those day campers learned to grow vegetables. And then the next day, after they harvested them, we brought in chefs to teach them how to cook those vegetables for themselves and their families. We gave these kids... It is something to be celebrated. We gave these kids snacks twice a day. Once a week, we put them on a bus and took them out on a field trip, either to a conservation area or a provincial park. We had workshops with Indigenous elders, Peter Schuler, Black historians, and every Thursday we had bins of groceries for the parents to take home when they came to pick up their kids, courtesy of Food for Life. 8 weeks, over $110,000 it cost us to put on that program. What do you think the cost was to parents and families?
Three.
On the initiative of Oakville Town Council, led by Mayor Rob Burton, in August this year, Button Bush Trail Park in Oakville was renamed Veronica Terrell Park. And the mayor at that park dedication went one step further, and he proclaimed August the 27th as Veronica Terrell Day in Oakville. So right now, here we are, Black History Month. CCH will host and collaborate on over 60 events in 28 days for Black History Month. We will touch the lives of over 100,000 Halton residents. And lastly, I wonder if in 45 years, the CCH president will ask if there is still the need to celebrate Black History Month, because Halton now celebrates Black people the other 11 months of the year.
Hi everyone, my name is Anita Anand, the Member of Parliament for Oakville. This year, the theme for Black History Month is connecting communities. I want to make sure that we recognize the importance of condemning racism and discrimination in all of their forms. And secondly, we must recognize not only the historical contributions that Black Canadians make, but also their current contributions to business, to nonprofit organizations, and to the cultural fabric of our community and country as a whole. So we must celebrate Black Canadians not only in February, but every single month of the year. Thank you.
Communities are all about people, and this year's theme of connecting communities means that we're connecting people, which in turn makes our communities more resilient, healthier, and more equitable.
Hi, I'm MPP Stephen Crawford. It's my pleasure to offer greetings and best wishes to the Black community of Oakville on Black History Month 2023. This year's theme is connecting communities, and we are focusing on the four pillars of education, culture, community, and harmony. As the Oakville community, we can create a space for people to listen and share, spotlight our stories, and volunteer our time and money while supporting diversity all year round. The Black community comprises a sizable portion of the fabric of Canada and contributes significantly to the prosperity and diversity of our town. On behalf of the Government of Ontario and myself, I would like to wish you a wonderful Black History Month for 2023.
Hello, everyone. I'm Burlington Mayor Marianne Mead Ward. To me, connecting communities means bringing people together to celebrate what is uniquely different about each of us, but also our shared values and goals and what unites us as a community to do great things together.
So I'd like to begin with a quotation from Diana's book. It's actually the quotation that begins her publication. It says, "Surface stories, the public, not the private ones, tell the tale known as history. Then there are the buried stories that live beneath the surface, waiting to be told." So I'd like to start with a story about a six-year-old Diana Cook who lived at Swallowfield Avenue, St. Andrew Parish in Jamaica. At 6 years old, she was already a voracious reader. And one day when she ran out of books, she decided it would be a good idea to go through her father's bookshelf, where she found a World War II history book. This book contained graphic pictures of the Holocaust, descriptions of Hitler's final solution, statistics on the 6 million killed, as well as statistics on the many other millions of combatants and other non-combatants that were killed in World War II. So, as you can see here on this map, just so that you can let your imagination engage with the scope of this project, when you think about World War II, and when you read history books about World War II, Jamaica is not something that is mentioned, and it's not a nation that immediately comes to mind. Its story is just one of the hidden histories waiting to be told. And in her publication, it is told through the stories of 17 of the survivors that were actually interned during World War II in Jamaica. Now, I find it very interesting that Jamaica's role in preserving thousands of refugees isn't included in history books, especially as a counter to accounts of the general apathy in the world regarding saving Jews fleeing from the Holocaust. If memory serves, Canada's response when asked how many Jews they would save from the concentration camps, the answer was, quote, "None is too many." So the story begins with logistics. Where were these refugees going to live? What you see here is you see what we are calling Gibraltar Camp 1 and 2. As you can see, the scope of Gibraltar Camp is quite stunning. It contains barracks, infrastructure, all sorts of administrative buildings. But here's the thing, and I think you'll be quite surprised. In approximately 5 months, 3,500 Jamaicans used 6 million feet of lumber to build what you see on the screen in front of you. Essentially, in a shockingly short amount of time, Jamaica built a small city to accommodate the Jews that were fleeing from Hitler's final solution. To give you an idea of what it looked like, in the top left corner, you'll see a close-up of the barracks that housed many of the families that were fleeing. In the bottom left, it gives you an idea of how this particular camp was organized. The walkways, the breezeways, outside dining areas. And these pictures were provided by the individual on the right, Ben Smith, who was one of the refugees. In this image, you see that infrastructure includes a constabulary office, and you can see that this is something that, although it is very different from the camps in Europe, there is still a great deal of infrastructure designed to keep the refugees on the ground of Gibraltar Camp. As you can see here, Camp Gibraltar also had a private bus. But before you run away with the idea that this is a fun kind of excursion vehicle, this was the bus that was in fact used when the refugees were allowed to go out on very carefully monitored outings, but also the children would be taken to school. It was also the bus that collected the refugees when they disembarked and brought them to the camp at the beginning. Here you see in one of the maintenance buildings that entire infrastructure was dedicated towards maintaining a camp of this size. And I particularly like this image because you see the manufacture of some of the signs. You'll notice it says Gibraltar Evacuee Camp Area. Trespassers will be prosecuted. So it gives you a bit of an idea of the nature. It allows you to imagine, if you will, the conditions in this particular camp. And what is interesting about this is this entire camp was supervised by the commandant. His name was Ernest Ray. Now, he was a West Indian cricketer and former deputy mayor of Kingston, and his deputy commandant, George Brown, also shared this vast responsibility. Interestingly, both were Jamaican men of color. And I do find it very telling that these men are not recognized in the annals of history. Now, in the course of our research, obviously, we were hoping to find a photograph of these people. And while we could not find a photograph of George Brown, we did find this image. And that is Ernest Ray at the back in the tie. And I think maybe a little participation might be in order. Who do you think that is? Take a look. And here's another picture, close up. If you think you recognize it, anyone, feel free to shout it out. No one? Shall I tell you? Ian Fleming, creator of Bond, James Bond. Despite what I think are considerable research skills that I possess, I was not able to penetrate British naval top secret documents to find out exactly what he was doing there. But again, I think this is a testament to the many, many stories that have yet to be told about this particular moment in World War II that is very special. I am going to suggest that you read Diana's book to find out exactly how this story ends.
Yeah! Thank you.
This Black History Month, the Halton Regional Police Service is honored to join the individuals and organizations who are coming together to build an equitable, strong, and inclusive region. A region where we can all feel safe, and a region we can all be proud to call home. Our service is also so proud to support the Canadian Caribbean Association of Halton in connecting communities and celebrating the rich history and achievements of the Black community here in Halton and far beyond. There is so much to celebrate. Happy Black History Month.